First time I ever went swimming with a whale was with a humpback whale in Bermuda. You know, nobody had swum with whales up until then. I thought, well, who cares if it's safe? It's interesting and beautiful. They will swim right over the top of you. And if there's 3 feet of water beneath you before you get to the bottom, you get crowded into that space, and it's very scary. When it turns in the water and moves its body around, you feel everything washing and rolling, and you think, my word, you know, am I gonna live through this? But you do. You always do. To a whale, there is practically nothing that that whale is disturbed by. So it can afford to live life in a peaceful fashion. It can explore the world and approach it with a confidence that no other species has except us. And even we don't have it, I believe, at the depth that whales have it. There are records of whales being killed only after 4 hours and 9 harpoons. It's a horrible way to kill an animal. It would be hard to imagine a worse one. About 10% of the total population of blue whales was killed in 1 year. If you can kill animals at a rate like that, there's no hope for them at all, absolutely none. Well, finally people realized, oh, I see, well, maybe we have a problem here. A wonderful scam has been invented by the whalers called scientific whaling. And what it is, actually, is the same people hunting the same whales, using the same equipment in the same places, and selling them to the same markets. But now it's science. When people finally understand what it is that's wrong in this world, they act fast. They act so fast that you can't even react.
Great, great, that's great. That is too much madness.
Margaret Mead was once asked, do you think that a single individual can make a difference? And as she pointed out, it's the only thing that ever has made a difference.